Australia is making global headlines tonight after the PM committed to the extraction and use of gas for the next three decades. That's despite fresh warnings from climate scientists that building a net zero policy around gas will contribute to locking in an increase in global temperatures of at least 2.7 degrees. Network political editor Ashleigh Raper joins me now. And Ash, the PM could be in some trouble here from within his own party.
Yes, Ursula, we have had a handful of MPs come out quite quickly after this announcement, which has been presented as a strategy going forward. And in this announcement, it really says that gas approvals will be, there'll be more gas projects, and they'll also be locked in, and it's really locking gas in until 2050. Now, some of these MPs have been more critical than others, but it is significant that they've come out so publicly when this has been a largely disciplined government that hasn't aired grievances so openly. But they're clearly concerned with the backlash from the Greens, who have come out quite strongly, from Teal Independence. So this could become a headache for the government.
But Ash, at least they're saying tonight we will all be feeling a little bit richer soon.
Yes, a little but not rich. Ahead of Tuesday's federal budget, the government has released some forecasts, and it's around disposable household incomes. And it suggests that they will grow by 3.5% next financial year. And that's because inflation is coming down, wages are up, and it's also to do with the Stage 3 tax cuts that will come in into effect on July the 1st. So, look, this is a glimmer of hope for households, but there will still be low-income households that are doing it incredibly tough and will be looking to the budget for more cost-of-living help, and that has been promised, Ursula.